Very good morning, friends. So I am Rahul Dhanote, assistant professor at Department of Botany, KJ Somaiya College of Arts, Commerce and Science, Koppargaon. And I am teaching you the subject that is horticulture and floriculture. So far, we have completed the first chapter, horticulture and floriculture. Now, today we are going to start with the second new chapter, that is horticultural plants. So let's start with the new chapter. Chapter 2, Horticultural Plants, in which we are going to study nutritive value of fruits and vegetables, classification of horticultural crops, and the classification of vegetables, fruits, ornamental plants, spices, and flowers. So let's see the functions of fruits and vegetables in human body. Fruits and vegetables provide palatability and taste. Then it improves appetite and provides fiber to overcome constipation. They also neutralize the acids produced during digestion of proteins and fatty acids. They improve the general immunity of human body against diseases and deficiencies. And they are the important source of vitamins and minerals used in several biochemical reactions occur in body. So vitamins generally used in various biochemical reactions in human body, and these vitamins are not produced by human body, so we need to take up it from outside the body in the form of fruits and vegetables. So this is the very important source of vitamins and minerals. Then fruits and vegetables provide higher energy value per unit area as compared to cereals. So some of the essential nutrients provided by different fruits and vegetables are, and what are the vitamins? Vitamin A. Okay, so let's see the role in human body of vitamin A and as well as source of vitamin A. So the role of vitamin A in human body is essential for growth and reproduction, helps in resistance to infections, increases longevity and decreases senility. Then second one is deficiency causes night blindness, xerophthalmia, retardation in growth, roughness in skin, formation of stones in kidney. Okay, so this is the deficiency of vitamin A, okay, due to which there is some diseases like night blindness, xerophthalmia, retardation in growth, roughness in skin, and formation of stones in kidney, which is caused due to the deficiency of vitamin A. Okay, so let's see the source of vitamin A. That is mango, papaya, dates, jackfruit, walnut, oranges, passion fruit, etc. Okay, these are the fruits which provides the vitamin A. Okay, and which are the vegetables which provides vitamin A? Which are coriander leaves, drumstick leaves, and fenugreek leaves. Okay, so these are the source of vitamin A, that is fruits and vegetables. Let's see the next vitamin, that is vitamin B1. Okay, so there are different types of vitamins. Okay, so they are like vitamin A, vitamin B, vitamin C, vitamin D, vitamin E, and vitamin K. Okay, so on the basis of their solubility, they are divided into two groups, that is water soluble and fat soluble. Okay, so vitamin B and C are water soluble vitamins, and vitamin A, vitamin D, vitamin E, and vitamin K are fat soluble vitamins. Okay, so let's talk about vitamin B1. Okay, so vitamin B again divided into vitamin B1 and B2 and many more. So let's see about the vitamin B1 and B2. Okay, so what is the role of vitamin B1 in human body? For maintaining good appetite and normal digestion, necessary for growth, fertility, lactation, and for normal functioning of nervous system. and deficiency causes. Okay, so due to the deficiency of vitamin B1. Okay, so what is the deficiency causes? Causes beriberi, paralysis, loss the sensitivity of skin, enlargement of heart, loss of appetite, and fall in body temperature. Okay, so vitamin B1 is also called as thiamine. Okay, so remember this point. Vitamin B1 is also called as thiamine. And what is the source of vitamin B1? That is walnut, apricot, apple, banana, grapefruit, plum, and almond. And also chilies, colocasia leaves, as well as tomato. So these are the fruits and some vegetables which provides or which are the source of vitamin B1. That is also called as thiamine. Okay, so let's see the next vitamin, that is vitamin B2. Okay, so vitamin B2 is also called as riboflavin. Okay, so remember these points. And what is the role of this vitamin B2 in human body? It is important for growth, health of skin, and for respiration in poorly vascularized tissues such as the cornea. And what is the deficiency causes of this vitamin B2? That is, it causes pellagra and alopecia, loss of appetite, loss of weight, sore throat, and development of cataract, as well as swollen nose and baldness. Now let's see the source of vitamin B2, that is bell, papaya, lychee, pomegranate, wood apple, and pineapple. And in vegetables, that is amaranthus and fenugreek leaves, which are the source of vitamin B2. So let's see the next vitamin, that is vitamin C, which is also called as ascorbic acid. Okay, so what is the role of vitamin C in human body? That is, deficiency causes scurvy, pain in joints, swelling of limbs, unhealthy gums, tooth decay, delay in wound healing, and rheumatism. Okay, so the deficiency of this vitamin C, okay, which leads to the diseases like scurvy, pain in joints, swelling of limbs, unhealthy gums, tooth decay, delay in wound healing, and rheumatism. And what are the source of vitamin C? That is Barbados, cherry, guava, lime, lemon, sweet oranges, bear, pineapple and pear, and vegetables, that is chilies, tomato, coriander leaves, drumstick leaves, and many more. Okay, so what are the next source of fruits and vegetables? That is fat. Okay, so dietary fats are essential to give your body energy and to support cell growth. They also help protect your organs and help keep your body warm. Fats help your body absorb some nutrients and produce important hormones. Okay, and the source of these fats are walnut, almond, avocado. These are the some source of fats. The next source, that is, or the next nutrient is fiber. Dietary fiber is found in cereals, fruits, and vegetables. Fiber is made up of the indigestible parts or compounds of plants, which pass relatively unchanged through our stomach and intestines. Fiber is mainly a carbohydrate. The main role of fiber is to keep the digestive system healthy. Okay, so this is the main function of fiber. That is, the main role of fiber is to keep the digestive system healthy. Let's see the source of fiber. That is guava, pomegranate, grape, mustard, beet leaf, spinach, and many more. Okay, so coriander. Coriander is also a good source of fiber in case of vegetables. Okay, so let's see the minerals. Okay, see about the minerals. Minerals are essential for the growth and development for the human body. So first one is calcium. Let's see the role of calcium. Calcium is one of the most important minerals for the human body. Why? Because it contributes in the formation of bones. It helps form and maintain healthy teeth and bones. A proper level of calcium in the body over a lifetime can help prevent osteoporosis, and the deficiency of calcium causes rickets and osteomalacia. And what are the source of calcium? That is sitafal, ramphal, fig, falsa, citrus, sapota, grapes, West Indian cherry, and many more. And in vegetables, that is curry leaves, amaranthus, radish leaves, and fenugreek leaves. So these are the source of calcium. And calcium, besides the help form and maintain healthy teeth and bones, it is also useful in cell signaling. Okay, so calcium is also useful in cell signaling. The next mineral is phosphorus, which is essential for cell multiplication of bones and soft tissues, and also helps in liberation of energy on oxidation of carbohydrate. And the source of phosphorus is wood apple, avocado, dates, pomegranate, and grape raisins. So these are the source of phosphorus. Let's see the next one, that is proteins, which is important for body growth, formation, and maintenance of body tissues. The source are West Indian cherry, avocado, custard apple, banana, apricot, guava, grapes. And in vegetables, that is peas, cowpea, bean, and many more. The next one is, that is iron. Okay, so iron acts as oxygen carrier in the body. Okay, so which is present in the hemoglobin, which transfers the oxygen throughout the body. What are the source of iron? That is Carunda, date palm, grape raisins, West Indian cherry, guava, sitafal, avocado, sapota, plum, and many more. And in vegetables, amaranthus and coriander leaves are the source of iron. Okay, so this is about the nutritive value of fruits and vegetables. Fruits are also a good source of energy. Example, avocado and olive. Okay, good source of energy in the form of proteins. Then fruits are also a good source of enzymes, which are helpful in metabolic activities leading to proper digestion of food. Example, jamun and papaya. All fruits have one or the other medicinal value. They should be eaten in adequate quantity. Regular consumption of fruits reduces obesity, maintain health, and increases the longevity of life. Okay, so regular consumption of fruits reduces obesity, that is fatness of the body. It also maintains the health and increases the longevity of life. So fruits are attractive in appearance, delicious in taste, and easily digestible. Therefore, they are liked by young and old alike. Okay, so this is the nutritive value of fruits and vegetables in human's daily life or in our daily life. So let's see the next point, that is classification of horticultural plants. India is endowed with rich vegetation wealth, with rich diversity of plant wealth. About 9,500 species of ethnobotanical interest have been recorded. Out of these, more than 50 types of fruits and vegetables, many individual types of spices, plantation crops, etc. are under commercial cultivation in different parts of the country under different sets of growing conditions. An attempt to deal with all these plants separately becomes tedious, cumbersome, and infeasible, and more so respective. To avoid these difficulties, it is better to classify the plants in groups based on similarity or dissimilarity of attributes. Okay, so to overcome the different difficulties these fruits and vegetables are classified based on some similarities or dissimilarities. Plants having similarity in either of the traits are placed under one group. Such type of grouping plants in different categories is referred to as classification. The overall objective of the classification is to systematize the presentation and make the remembrance of the plants easy and convenient. Generally, based on botanical relationships, the plants are classified. Okay, so let's see different groups of plants are classified based on the following criteria. So what are the criteria in the classification of fruits? Fruits are classified on the basis of nature of their growth, then on the basis of climatic requirement, on the basis of continuation of growth, on the type of fruit, on the salinity tolerance, on the basis of ripening behavior, and on the basis of photoperiodic requirements. So on the basis of this, the fruits are classified into different groups. So let's see the first one, that is classification based on nature of growth. Okay, so on the basis of nature of growth, fruits are classified as follows. Okay, so on the basis of growth, these are classified like herbaceous, shrubaceous, and into trees. Okay, so what is herbaceous? Herbs are soft stem plants and usually have leafy structure and they do not have woody structure. Example of herbaceous plants are fruits like banana and pineapple. Second one is shrubaceous, that is usually height is 10 to 12 feet and have several stem arising at or near the ground. And the example of shrubaceous plants are fruits, that is corunda and pomegranate and many more. Then trees, a woody perennial plant typically having a single stem or trunk growing to a considerable height and bearing lateral branches at some distance from the ground. Okay, so these plants falls under the category of trees. And example of this trees are, that is mango, guava, apple, sapota, etc. Okay, so this is the classification based on nature of growth. Let's see the second one, that is classification of fruits based on climate adaptability. On the basis of this, in this classification, the fruit trees are categorized into three recognized groups, that is temperate fruits, tropical fruits, and subtropical fruits. So let's talk about temperate fruits. In temperate region, the conditions are cold and humid climate. Temperate fruit plants are exciting in their climate requirement. They are grown only in place where winter is distinctly cold, require as exposure of specific chilling temperature for certain period, without which they do not flower. These fruit plants are generally deciduous and stand frost. Example, apple, almond, peach, pear, plum, strawberry, apricot, walnut, cherry, and kiwi fruits. Okay, so these fruits plants are generally deciduous. Deciduous plants means which sheds their leaves. The second one is tropical fruits, in which the condition are hot and dry. Tropical fruit plants are generally evergreen and are extremely sensitive to cold. They do well under lesser fluctuations of diurnal temperature, light and dark periods. They require a moist, warm climate, but are capable of withstanding dry weather in some cases. And example of this type are mango, banana, papaya, and sapota. The third category is subtropical fruits. in which the conditions are hot and very humid. The fruit crops grown under a climatic condition between temperature and the tropical are known as subtropical fruit crops. They may be either deciduous or evergreen and are usually able to withstand a low temperature but not the frost. They are also quite adaptive to fluctuations of light and dark period during day and night. Some subtropical fruit plants require chilling for flower bud differentiation. Example of this type are grape, citrus, durian and jackfruit. So this is the classification based on climatic adaptability, that is temperate fruits, tropical fruits and subtropical fruits. So let's move on to the next classification, which is based on continuation of growth. Okay, so I think we should stop here. This is enough for today. So stay safe, stay home, and happy learning. Thank you.